Hi friends, welcome to another video on Tutorials Point with me, Richa. And today in this aviation module segment, we will talk about carry-on baggage and checked-in baggage. Well friends, if you have traveled by airlines, you might have wondered how or what regulates these baggages. When are you allowed to carry a particular bag or not allowed to carry? What are the rules and regulations and the protocols to be followed with regards to baggage? So in this module, we will cover with regards to what are these protocols for baggages. Let's get started. On the agenda today, we will talk about what exactly is a carry-on baggage, checked-in baggages, contents of carry-on baggage as well as checked-in baggage in terms of what you are allowed to carry and not allowed to carry. Don'ts to be followed with regards to baggages, certain baggage protocols to be followed. Crew baggage as well as how and where they need to store their particular baggage. So that's on the agenda today. Let's immediately take a look at them. Well, what exactly is carry-on baggage? If we have to define a carry-on baggage, here is a dictionary definition of the same. A carry-on baggage is also known as a hand baggage, or it is also known as a cabin baggage, which is a term you use interchangeably with regards to carry-on baggage. It is a type of luggage that passengers are allowed to carry inside the passenger cabin of a vehicle instead of moving it to the cargo department. So carry-on baggage, which is also known as a hand luggage, can be carried by passengers inside the cabin and does not have to be put inside the cargo hold of that particular aircraft. Well, certain protocols for carry-on baggage. You cannot carry a very huge set of suitcases or handbags as a cabin baggage. So there are certain protocols to be followed. The total weight of a carry-on baggage cannot exceed more than 7 kgs. This is only for the pure purpose that if everybody starts carrying very heavy baggages inside the cabin, the total weight of the aircraft will really become too much and it can come into the way while takeoff and landing. The sum of the baggage dimensions, meaning the length, the width, as well as the height, may not exceed 115 centimeter or 45 inches. So that's a protocol to be followed with regards to hand baggage. And this is checked by the security staff as well as the ground personnel or reservation staff when you're doing a check-in. Objects that need to be properly secured. Passengers' personal items must never come, or in the way, or rather should not disturb or endanger other persons on board. So you have to keep in mind that the products or the objects you put inside a carry-on baggage should not make any other passenger endangered or affect the safety of that passenger. Let's understand what are checked-in baggages. Well, as carry-on baggages could be carried inside the cabin, the checked-in baggage cannot be carried inside the cabin. It has to be put in the cargo hold of the plane. So checked-in baggage refers to the items of the luggage which is delivered to an airline or train for transportation in the hold of the aircraft, that is the cargo, front as well as back of the cargo. Of a passenger train, which means it is inaccessible to the passengers during the flight phase of the flight. So what we are really trying to say is that the passenger do not have any access to the checked-in baggage once it gets checked in and into the cargo hold. A passenger cannot really have access to them. Well, certain points to be remembered with regards to checked-in baggage. Let's take a look at them. Identify your baggage for easy recognition during disembarkation at your arrival. Well, your checked-in baggage, friends, should have an identity card or should be easily recognizable so that it does not get mixed with the other passenger bags. Hence, there has to be an ID card. Do not carry baggage that is not yours or baggage which content to you is unknown. So only make sure that you are getting your checked-in baggage, not somebody else's. Do not check baggage containing valuable items. Well, if you are carrying valuable items like gold or diamonds or anything like that, it has to be carried in the carry-on baggage. So any valuables must not be checked in. If at all you are checking it into your checked-in baggage, make sure you secure it with a lock. These objects must be carried preferably, as we mentioned, in your carry-on baggage or your cabin luggage. Coming to important points for carry-on baggage, let's take a look at them. Carry-on baggages must not contain any kind of cutting or piercing objects. So objects which are sharp, for example, knife or nail cutter or you know, something which can hurt another passenger is not allowed to be carried. Such items have to be transported into checked-in baggage only. Well, friends, if you are checking in into the domestic airline, then their procedures of carry-on baggage is different with regards to restrictions. And if you are checking in at the international terminal, they have certain different rules and regulations with regards to particular things that you can carry in your carry-on baggage. But generally, most of the airlines do not allow you to carry certain products or certain items. Let's look at them. Well, most of the airlines do not allow liquids to be carried on either a domestic or even an international flight. There are certain rules and regulations regarding them. You can allow, or rather you are allowed to carry liquids of only 100 ml. Anything beyond 100 ml will not be allowed to be carried on board the aircraft. You need to make sure that you are packing your liquids in a transparent resealable bag so that it is viewable. And you also need to make sure that the bag that you carry with the liquids should not exceed 20 by 20 centimeter. One bag per person is allowed, and sealed bags must be presented or shown to the security staff whenever you're carrying them. Well, you're not allowed to carry liquids, gel, paste, even pickles, for example, are not allowed to be carried. Anything which is more than 100 ml will be confiscated by the security staff. Even if you're carrying water, drinkable water, but it is beyond 100 ml, it will be confiscated by security. Well, a carriage of liquids, as you mentioned, in a carry-on baggage must only be in a sealed pack so that the security staff can look at it and allow you to carry if it is only less than 100 ml. Certain exemptions are there for who liquids more than 100 ml is allowed. Let's, friends, look at what these exemptions are. For passengers who are boarding or making connections, liquid purchased at duty-free shops are allowed and they are exempted. So if you are traveling from India to any other abroad city, probably Dubai or Singapore, Mexico, etc., what you are allowed is you might be carrying liquid, you know, at which you have purchased at the duty free, you are allowed to carry that. Passenger needs to make sure that you have a receipt available if you have purchased anything from the duty free. Security will allow you to carry it. Any medicines that you are carrying which has more than 100 ml, but it has to have a prescription of a doctor, only then you will be allowed to carry it. Infant food or any other kind of liquid for special need of a passenger can be carried, and that's another exemption to this particular you know, idea of having only 100 ml. So these, my friends, are the exemptions. Certain prohibited items that you are not allowed to carry in your carry-on baggages: you cannot carry any kind of weapons, a knife, a bomb, a revolver, a pistol, any kind of weapon is not going to be allowed. Well, friends, even if it's a toy weapon, if you're traveling with a child and he's carrying a toy gun, it is not going to be allowed and it will be confiscated. Sharp objects like knives, nail cutters, etc. are not allowed. Blunt objects which can hurt any particular passenger. Explosives or flammable substances, anything which can catch fire quickly, is not going to be allowed because it can endanger other passengers' life on board the aircraft. Any kind of toxic or chemical substances like paint, aerosol, etc. are not going to be allowed. Magnetic materials, anything which has magnetic power and it can attract other magnetic powers, is something that will not be allowed to be carried. So friends, the next time you're traveling by airlines, you have a list of do's and don'ts with regards to what is allowed and what is not allowed to be carried inside a carry-on baggage. Well, let's understand certain checked-in baggage statement of valuable items. During check-in procedures, you can inform the airline staff about certain valuable items that you might be carrying inside your checked-in baggage. Now, what the crew, the ground staff, will help you with is giving you a kind of a fragile item, you know, a label which you can put on your checked-in baggage. It is good to inform the ground staff if you're carrying any kind of valuable thing inside the checked-in baggage. Now, there are times when you might want to carry your pet. It can be an animal of, you know, cat, dog, parrot, rabbits, etc. But they are not allowed to be carried inside the cabin, that is where the passengers are seated, until and unless it is being carried by a blind passenger. A blind passenger is allowed to take a dog who is able to help him make a journey. So that is the exemption. Generally, animals are allowed in the forward cargo of the aircraft for the simple reason that the forward cargo has AC or air conditioning, and even dead bodies are carried in the forward cargo. So to transport animals, you have to submit an animal health certificate, which is provided by the State Secretary of Agriculture, the Animal Defense Department, or even by accredited veterinarian. So that's a certificate that you need to carry in case you're transporting animals by air. Well, that can be really devastating when you come to the destination and you have a lost luggage. What do you do in such a situation? Let's quickly take a look. Well, for lost baggage policy, you need to inform immediately the airline staff of the airline that you're traveling in that you have lost your baggage. You need to provide official document. So in your checked-in baggage, they have a slip which is there put on your boarding card. You need to show that to the airline staff, which is like a document for you. Airline to return the baggage found. If it is at all found, they have to address it, or rather return it to the address of the passenger. The passenger's address is always there with the ground staff, so they will return it. While the policy is for baggage to be found within 30 days for domestic and within 21 days for an international airline, that is something that the airline needs to keep in mind to return it within these specified days only. Else, an airline has to refund the passenger depending on what their norms and protocol is with regards to lost baggage. Well, that can be again a very tricky situation wherein you come to the final destination wherein you're traveling and you have a damaged baggage. Either it has been opened or it has been tampered with. What do you do in such a situation? Let's see. As soon as you notice that your baggage has been damaged, immediately report the problem to the airline company, preferably still while you are at the waiting area. So, you know, at the waiting arrival hall of your particular destination, immediately inform the airline staff, preferably the manager, that you have had a damaged bag. It is important to know that a written communication of the fact may be registered within 7 days from the date of disembarkation. Well, you still have 7 days to write a written note to the airline in case your baggage has come back in a damaged state. That can be again a situation wherein your baggage has had a theft, means somebody has opened and removed certain valuable items from your bag. As soon as you discover that your baggage has been stolen, contact the airline and report the matter immediately through a written communication. Well, the airline is responsible for the baggage that they have taken from you, and it is checked until the moment you receive it back. So it is the airline's code of conduct, or it is their responsibility to make sure that you get your baggage back in an absolutely good condition. And if it has been stolen, it is the airline's responsibility. And they have to ascertain the fact in a written communication in case your baggage has been stolen or there has been a theft. Well, friends, that brings us to a conclusion on this particular module under aviation, which is of carry-on baggage and checked-in baggage. I do hope you have understood all about carry-on baggage and checked-in baggage. Keep listening, more videos coming your way. Thank you for watching us.